Okay, we need to edit the button script on the auto probing. So I'm gonna show how to fix a couple of things, questions people were asking about. Okay, first thing you want to do is go up to operator, then edit button script, click that, and you'll notice all the buttons that you can edit the script will start flashing. Okay, the one I want to work on right now is this button one here for the corner probe. The script editor will pop up with the code in it. Somebody is asking about removing the Z probe part of the corner buttons. That's as easy as this first section of code under where it says current feed. You just select from the get OEM LED down to end if, highlight all that and just cut it. So now all you're left with is the current feed at the top, and then it says VB script for probing in the X negative direction. That's for the button number one. Under this next line where it says if get OEM LED 825 equals zero, you want to change it to less than or greater than, like it is down in the Y direction. Some machines work fine with the equal zero, but other machines need it to be less than or greater than. So just remove the equals and change it to less than or greater than. Less than or greater than. Still didn't do the less than. Alright. Change that. So now it says 825 in parentheses, less than, greater than, zero, then. That's the same way as it says down here for probing in the Y direction. That's all we'll need to use for just probing in the X and the Y on the corner button. Okay, once we're done changing those, just go up to the corner and click the X to close the window. It'll pop up, do you want to save the changes in the hidden script? Click yes. And there we go. I've got my keyboard set up. This isn't the mill computer. I can hit button Q to simulate the probe hitting. See the light flashing. Tells you you're out with Z. Now, once you've removed the Z probe, you're going to have to position the your tool probe down below the edge of your part now, since it won't do it automatically with since the Z probe's been removed. So for like this corner button, it's going to do the X positive move, so you're going to have to set your tool up to the left of the part and down below the edge of the part, because once you hit the button, it's going to start moving the X in the positive direction. Yeah. So we'll simulate that one. Do a corner probe now. Alright, you can see the X drove moving in a positive. Okay, we'll simulate we hit it. Alright, now it's going to move out to do the Y. Alright, now it's moving in to do the Y. We simulate we hit it. And there we go. Reset it. So you'd go through and change all the corner button codes, remove that first section that's for the Z probe, and then you just got to remember to physically position your tool outside of the part and below the edge. It's going to do the X moves first, so you want to be out on the outside of the X on each corner. Okay, another thing I was asked about was changing the my metric tool probe codes. Apparently I have it set at 25.4 millimeters, which is, you know, 1 inch. Somebody from Croatia wanted it changed to their 20 or 30 millimeters, a nice round number. I really didn't think about that when I wrote it up. That's probably what they would rather have. So I have the Z probe button now set for the metric code, so just go back through to edit that a little bit out. We go up to operator, edit button script, the button will flash. This is the Z probe button, it's flashing. We just click it, up will pop the script editor. We just go up into the code. Okay, here code is G1Z25.4. So we just highlight the 25.4 and delete it and change it to whatever you want, 20 or 30, you know, millimeters, whatever you guys want. Just change that to 30 and you're good to go. You go up to the corner of the window and click close. It'll pop up asking you to save the changes. Click yes and now you're done. Now when you hit the Z button, now we'll go ahead and change, test it. It's gonna show 30 on mine, but there, we're simulating doing the Z probe. It's going down. Okay, it hit. Now well, it's technically going to 30 inches on mine, but you get the idea. And so there you go. When it's done, it'll now retract up to 30 on the Z. And that's all there is to it. Operator, edit button script. Whatever you change, make sure you tell it yes to save the changes.